The G string definitely helps with the compound third stuff and the fact that I like to play a lot of parts with an open G string. Two sort of prominent tunes, the Hold Back the River. I'll turn it up for you. Hold Back the Rivers. And Let It Go. Both of those, the backbone is the G string, basically, because I use a lot of sort of left hand muting and dampening, and right hand muting and everything, but particularly, you know, on the frets, I sort of pull off very slightly, and yeah, kind of dampen the notes. But that G string, I kind of always need it running through as, like I say, the kind of backbone of the part. Because if at any point I'm not playing, so that you still get sound. Because if at any point I'm not fretting any notes, I've still got that guy to rely on. Because I've got to change those shapes, you know, so I've got to take my fingers off those notes. And I, you know, if I didn't have the G string, there's all these gaps. And it just didn't sound very good. And the same with Let It Go. You know, if I didn't have the G string, it'd be... You know, and I use three fingers, right? So it's even hard to play. The G string is something I can fall back on as well. I just love its consistency and it's open and it's always ringing true and there's never gonna be. I love the variation, all within one part, there's variation between different parts. I've got this fretted sort of muting sound with the fingers and the notes that I'm fretting. And then I got that guy, this sort of lone wolf G string, just like playing through.